at one forward. They're not a very big team. And Troy Rountree will be the other forward in tonight's game. The officials for this evening's game, the referee is Brad Gaston. The umpires, Mark Mayhood and Mike Lisenfelder. Our good friend Boomer is here tonight. Jim Bain, one of the great all-time officials and outstanding representative of the Missouri Valley Conference, is here tonight. And now to honor America, our national anthem. Both teams lined up, free throw line extended. Bradley right in front of us. We're behind the Bradley bench. The Braves in the first half will move from our left to right. There's no television for the game tonight. If you're listening on the internet on BUBraves.com or WMBD.com, we welcome you tonight. Thanks for being with us for Bradley basketball. And now from Carver Arena to honor America in our final home game before the Valley season and the Christmas season and Coach Stoll's birthday, our national anthem.
Peoria, as she leads the Alumni and Friends Band playing of the national anthem, directed by Dave Roman.
From Carver Arena, the Hornets of Delaware State. Their colors are navy blue and red. They have red uniforms with the navy blue and white trim. The Braves in the home white, trimmed in black and red. And the announcement of the starting lineup coming up in just a second. Our Heritage Bank starting lineups for both teams. First of all, the keys to the game, Coach. Here we go. Have the lead at halftime.
Always a good idea.
Yep. They're 0-5, the Hornets, when they trail at halftime. Win on the boards.
Yeah, well, I think we're going to do that.
They're 0-6 when they've been out-rebounded. And get into the 70s. That might be a trick.
That might be a trick. That's probably the hardest one so far.
And defensively, force a dozen turnovers. They're about like Butler as far as turning it over, not because of the great ball handling that they have, but because there aren't many possessions in the game. So force a dozen turnover, Blunt and Shine, less than 20 points combined, another 40% from the field. Magic number tonight, Coach?
I'm going to go with the guess, 66.
I have 60.
Oh, so conservative tonight, Dave.
Get
well,
ready.
You know they're only averaging 51 a game,
that's
Dave.
That's right. That's a pretty good guess. This is something I've never seen, Coach. The players for the Hornets going over and shaking hands with the officials.
Always a good idea, though, Dave.
Well, at least, yeah, they're all going to do it. Well, that is something to note, and that's great. Darren Shine, 31 minutes, the 5'9", 170 junior from Augusta, Georgia, 5.8 points a game. And Joshua Blunt, 33, 6'6", junior from Los Angeles, averaging 13.4. He is their best player. And the man in the middle is 34, Aaron Fleetwood, 6'9", 210, junior from Raleigh, North Carolina, 5 points a game. He had 10 against Wichita State, Valley member of the board, and Jacksonville State. Richard Rountree, open the ball for the night. 6'5", 225, junior from Philadelphia, 5 points a game. Had 15 as a career high against South Carolina State. Joe Dickens, 6'7", 195, junior. From Baltimore, Maryland, averaging 8 points a game. And 23, Tracy Worley, 6'3", 190. Sophomore from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 5.3. Worley, 23. Dickens, 35. Rountree, 42. Fleetwood, 34. And Darren Shine. Darren Ray or Shine. 0-0 for the 2-6 Hornets of Greg Jackson. And now Heritage Bank. Starting lineup from Peoria High with 30 minutes a game. Daniel Rupp, 5'10", 165, sophomore from the Lions. Running mate, Tony Bennett. Bing to me, Tony. Number 5, 6 foot, 170, senior from Chicago Westinghouse. Averaging 12.5 points, 5.2 rebounds per game. Zach Andrews. I told him we should call him Jaws. Like the old start. Number 21, 6'8", 251, junior from Yuba Junior College. 9.5, this is in the hand for Zach.
Well, he deserved it, Dave. 2 games he started, he's been something.
8.3 rebounds, he had a career high 19. And the win against Western Kentucky. Lawrence Wright, 6'4", 200 pounds, senior from Wheatland, California, Yuba Junior College in California. 11.7 and 5.5 rebounds a game. And Marcella Somerville, 6'7", 225, senior from Peoria High. 17.3 points, 6.8 rebounds per game. Sellis is now 32nd in scoring with Bradley. 1,079, 28 behind Charles White, 20 behind Rich Schultz, the player that you had coached school years ago. And 24 points behind number 29, Donald Reese. He's also 10th on the all-time threes made list. Number 9 is Marcello Robinson, and he'll pass him with 2 this evening.
Marcello, as I see, is down behind the bench tonight, along with Jason Faulkner, Dave.
They're here at about every game.
Yeah.
They just love the game.
They're standing there with Chuck Wessendorf and Steve Doty. I think they're here about every game, too.
Well, they don't miss much. There's a lot of brain power there, Coach Stoll. I'll tell you what. When we used to have a PE major, you put out some outstanding coaches that played for you.
Well, it's nice to say that, Dave. And they're good people. They've done a good job in coaching, and they've retired now, but they're still active, and they've done a good job where they coach too.
And we're about ready to go. It will be the Braves moving from left to right in the first half. Moving into jump will be Aaron Fleetwood, the 6'9" junior. To jump probably against Zach Andrews.
I think he's got skinnier legs than Boogie.
And that's hard to do.
That is hard to do.
Wherever you are in the Midwest, happy holidays to each and every one of you. And we hope you enjoy Bradley basketball as the Braves take on Delaware State. The ball's in the air and tipped to Somerville. And Bradley with the first possession, and there's Ruff with it. With a right-hand dribble between the rings, gives to Lawrence Wright at a high post. Running off a screen, posting inside was Zach Andrews. Now he gets it up high from Ruffin. Look for the drop-down pass. Zach going to go to the basket. Nice drop-down pass, Lawrence Wright, and he's fouled to go to the line. 18 seconds into the game with 2 free throws. Bradley scores per game. 74-3, gives up 69. Their numbers 51-9 scoring and 59 giving up. Dickens picks up the foul, his first. And
nice
the first
pass,
foul of the game.
You call it, Dave, a good drop down pass.
First free throw is good by Lawrence Wright. How's Boogie at the line? He's now 24 of 34, adding on to the 70%, and he'll have one more. 1-0. Let's see if the Braves pressure and try to speed this team up. Free throw number 2 is good.
Not bad on it.
Here comes the pressure. Roundtree looks to inbound. They set a ball screen, and moving to it is Dickens. Still in the backcourt. And to bring it up across the timeline himself. And now in the corner on the left, here's a jumper fired up by, or they look to fire the jumper, Worley, who gets it back. He'll bring it up top. Shot clock reads 20. They've got
Zach,
the floor
Zach
spread.
Really out there defense in the midcourt.
Give to Roundtree. He wears number 42. He's got a beard. He looks like he's about 30. With it is Shine. Going out to help is Somerville. He drives to the right with 6'5 and a shot clock. Bounce pass to the baseline and a walk. There's a stop, 50 seconds in, and the first turnover of the game for the Hornets. You won't have to play, you got to play defense all the time, but they kind of lull you to sleep. That's what they want. 2-0 Bradley on 2 free throws.
Ball
by
back
Lawrence
into
Wright.
The zone this time, looks like, Dave.
It's the 1-2-2, Coach.
Oh, it's the start down. Well,
are they matching up on it?
Here's a trying to match up.
There's a skip pass to Somerville. Lob inside Lawrence Wright. Has it knocked away out of bounds with 21 on the shot clock. Inbound, baseline left. 18:55 to play in the first half. And it'll be Daniel Ruffin to inbound.
2-3 zone on inbounds.
Boogie goes to the corner. Rays have been very good at scoring on inbounds plays this year. Give it to Lawrence Wright, and a bounce pass is to Ruffin, and Bennett touches it for the first time in the offense. Entry pass, Lawrence Wright. They three-time a great pass inside. Zach Andrews from Lawrence Wright for the field goal as
good
he cut down the lane.
Right, Zach came right down the middle.
Yuba 4, Delaware State nothing. Two each for Andrews and Wright. And they'll be patient again. Worley with it. He wears number 23 in the red-clad uniforms. Takes a look. And a bounce pass is Roundtree, who comes way out front. Fleetwood is almost invisible, coach, in their offense. He just is down there hanging around.
Yeah.
With it is Dickens. Gives there is Fleetwood. The ball's taken away by Ruffin. Second turnover. Ruff on the glide, on the move. Pull up 18-footer. That bounce is no good. Andrews went for the rebound and got the rim and couldn't get the ball. And here comes Darren Shine across the timeline with a 4-0 Bradley lead. A hop, a skip. Nice feed pad is inside for the goal. Sits everybody down as Roundtree scores on the excellent assist by Fleetwood, and it's 4-2. With it is Bennett. Now Ruffin. Up top is Lawrence Wright. Somerville has not taken a shot. Free throw line extended to the left. 17-38 for the first half. Bradley 4, Delaware State 2. Bennett with it against the zone.
They're matching up, Ava Dave.
I was going to say, coaches, there's a lob to the basket and a foul and a hook on Lawrence Wright, an offensive foul. First turnover of the game for the Braves at 17-30. It'll be inbound for Delaware State. And the first foul of the game to Bradley goes to Lawrence Wright on a hook, and that was a good call. So it's going to be Roundtree to inbound. He's having trouble keeping that shirt tail tucked in, coach. It's creeping out on him. Now he's going to tie the pants.
We're not guarding the ball out of bounds, Dave, and we're going to trap him when they get it in.
They're going to try to deny Darren Shine, who sets a ball or a screen away from play for Dickens, and then Shine goes and gets. Darren Shine, 5'9", junior guard from Augusta, Georgia, brings it across the timeline, and Lawrence Wright has him. Give to Tracy Worley. And now Bennett goes out on him. Roundtree, put it down to the floor, 2-3 times with the left hand. Now with the right hand, brings it between the rings, 15-14 on the shot clock. Looks to move, pass out in front, is to Fleetwood. And a hold on, is going to be called on Zach Andrews on a hand check with 10 on the shot clock and 17-04. First foul on Zach's second team, reloaded to 35 at 17-04 and a 4-2 Bradley lead. And so they'll work the shot clock again. Shine gives to Tracy Worley. Get it between the rings, now backs up. Bennett's on him. You would think, coach, of this offense, they'd run some backdoor Princeton stuff, but they don't really.
No, they're not going to be in any hurry to shoot it, though.
There, Shine goes all the way down the lane. Flip it up and get it. Tie the game. Nice move by Darren Shine. Quickly at the other end, Bennett from Ruffin. His jumper's up and bounce away, no good. And the rebound taken down by Aaron Fleetwood. And the coach, Greg Jackson, says, slow it down. 16 and a half to play first. 4-4 is the score. Bradley scored the first four. Next four go to the Hornets. Shine with it between the rings. Take a look to the right. Popping out and wanting to get was Dickens. Penetrate and kick. But Fleetwood will bring it back out on top. Now he looks for the outlet, and there's Shine. Bounce pass it a block to block. Layup, good. Nice penetration. And the ball was, they're going to take it away.
Backwards, no basket.
As somebody got their hand in the rim, I think it might have been Fleetwood. Just committed a Fleetwood Mac.
No, I really did. Because of a fine pass.
That was a layup, and somebody got his hand in the cylinder. And now it looks like a 2-3 zone with official time coming in the next dead ball.
It was 2-3 then, matching up of it.
With it is Somerville. Ball fake, didn't take the shot as he took a step. Ruffin with it. Braves are a bad pass. Somerville knocked out of bounds. It'll go back to Bradley with 16 on the shot clock. Struggling a little bit against his zone here. 4-4, 15, 52 to play first half. Bradley with 16 on the shot clock. We'll have it when we come back in a minute. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD.
Hey, coach, could you hand me that clock in front of you, please?
This guy?
Thank you.
That's really right.
Yeah. Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sable. Happy holidays, everybody. Welcome back to Carver Arena. 4-4 is the score here early. The pace of this game is going to be a lot different than the other night. Bradley Breeze Basketball brought to you by Illinois American Water Company. Proud to provide you with quality water service, and by Heritage Bank of Central Illinois. Proud to support Bradley Basketball and the communities they serve. Heritage Bank professionals gladly give their time and talent to many local organizations. Coach, Dave, you might have to set an alarm clock here before too long.
Dave, we're 1 out of 3 from the field. They're 2 out of 2. Actually, 3 out of 3, the one they had on the takeaway. The one, you know, you get a little frustrated. You got to play defense 25 or 30 seconds every time and then come down, you know, and you're used to playing fast, and you may not get as good a shot as you want. So it has been at their tempo thus far.
15:52 to play, first half. Lawrence Wright, Zach Andrews, Daniel Ruffin, Marcella Somerville, and Tony Bennett.
Showing a 2-3 zone.
On the floor for the Braves with 16 on the shot clock. 4-4 is the score. And Ruffin will get the inbound from Lawrence Wright. Wright and Andrews have the goals in the game. Pass it to high post is to Somerville. Now he comes out a ways, looks to go to the wing on the right. 8 on the shot clock, now 7. Ruffin with 6, look at the entry pass with 5. Somerville, 3-point shot left, good! The 40th of the year. He's one away from number 9 on the all-time list, held by Marcello Robinson. 7-4 is the Bradley lead on the 3-ball. And here they'll work the clock again. It's Roundtree with it. Where's 42? He's a big man out near the timeline. Now to Schein. Darren Schein wears his number 0 between the rings against the man-to-man. Now on the left, it's Dickens. Schein, pass out front, is to Worley. Now it's Roundtree with 6-5 on the shot clock. Now with 4, not going to get a good shot. Fires a 3, bounce it, no good. Rebound is taken down and off the leg, out of bounds. There's a break. It was off the leg of Joe Dickens, as he had good positions on Lawrence Wright that time. But it went off his leg and out of bounds.
One thing that helps us, Dave, we generally play good man-for-man defense. A lot of teams will have maybe a big guy or, you know, that they can't guard anybody, and they're in trouble when they have a team to stretch out like this. But all our big players can play man-to-man pretty well.
7-4, the Bradley lead. Ruffin, high post passes. Lawrence Wright, come to the left. Tony Bennett, 3-ball Tony. That's good! Back-to-back threes. And Jeremy Crouch will come into the next dead ball. It's 10-4. Bradley with a 6-point lead. Bennett with a 3, Somerville with a 3. 4 of the 5 Braves have scored, everybody but Ruff. Here's Schein in the lane. Bounce pass thrown at the feet, taken away by Bennett, and he's fouled by Roundtree. His first, second team at 14-27. And with a 6-point lead, J.J. Twy comes in for the first time, and he replaces Daniel Ruffin, who gets the blow at 14-27. Lawrence Wright is out. And Jeremy Crouch is in. You got to get Jeremy going here. And substitution time for Joshua Blunt, who we thought was going to start the game, did not. Alan Walker is in. Walker is a 6-foot sophomore from Augusta, Georgia. Blunt is their leading scorer, 6'6", 220, junior from Los Angeles. So J.J. Twy with it. J.J.'s played very well. We'll see Will Franklin, I'm sure, in a little bit. Crouch with it, free throw line extended on the right, bounce pass to the high post to Zach Andrews. Somerville was posting inside and now gets it from J.J. They three-time him, give it to Crouch, takes a dribble, looks for the return pass on the post, and it's taken away. Jeremy made a bad pass that time, and it was fronted on the post. Second Bradley turnover, 6 minutes in. All the way down, Crouch is late getting there and missed the shot as going in to take the shot was Fleetwood. He missed it at the other end. Here's Bennett layup. Good! From J.J. Twy.
Got the ball out real well that time.
12-4. 5 points for Tony Bennett. 13:40 to play in the first half. Bradley 12, Delaware State 4.
We ran the last 8 in a row, Dave.
Walker gives to Fleetwood, and he's out there. Zach Andrews sags on him about 8 feet. Give to Worley. They got a 1-4 low set this time. And they're going to set a ball screen and a switch Zach Andrews as he doubles along with Somerville against Worley. This is great Bradley defense here. Passing lane shut down in time. With 5 on the shot clock and 13-15, Zach Andrews and Somerville both trapped, and he had nowhere to go except to the official to call timeout.
That's a bit where he got an advantage, Dave, with Big Ben. He can guard people on the perimeter.
Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by the Unlin Companies. Take the hassle out of buying insurance with one call. They're in the white and yellow pages. The Unwin Companies, where it's about you. We have somebody else come in, Watts. Number five, Elon Bush. 6'5", 195 junior from Fredericktown, Maryland, averaging 4.4 per contest. So Bush is in there along with Walker. They've changed almost their entire lineup here. A Blunt, still not as bad as Drake, but Fleetwood remains in the game. And Worley, they've got a smaller lineup, even smaller here. 5-4 on the shot clock. With it, Fleetwood with three. Drives with two. Puts it up a 10-footer with one on the shot clock.
He got two good a shot and 5 seconds to go there, Dave.
12-6. Fleetwood gets his first deuce. Sam Singh will come in the next dead ball for the team in white. With it, Tony Bennett. Gives Somerville. Three ball, corner right. That's good.
Marcellus off to a good start.
He's got 2 3-balls in. 15-6. The Bradley lead is 9. Singh and Ray Brown will come in on the next dead ball. With it is Fleetwood. Looks right, looks and gives. They got a lot out of nothing last time. Worley with it out near the timeline. With a right-hand dribble comes up top to the right, high right. With it is Fleetwood. Watches Worley run through the lane. He doesn't get it. Bush wanted to get it. Now a drive, Roundtree. Drop it off for a pull-up jumper up from the right side. No good by Worley, and a rebound taken down by the Braves. And here comes J.J. Twy with it. Across the timeline, give to Andrews. Entry pass nicely done to Somerville, who's rimming no good. And the rebound's knocked out of bounds. It'll belong off the Braves. At 12-13 to play in the first half, Sam Singh in the lineup, 6'9", 260, freshman from Ozark, Missouri. He comes in for Zach Andrews. Boogie will come back. Tony Bennett is out. And Ray Brown comes in for him, 6'6", 190, freshman from Richfield, Minnesota, 15-9. I really like the fact that Jim got J.J. in there, Coach, because it just wasn't automatic that Will was going to come in and take that backup role. J.J. has deserved that. Roundtree steps out of bounds and turns it over. 12-11.
That wasn't off the trap, just a pretty good defense by Singh there, Dave.
That was one step in and one step on. Fifth turnover. A team doesn't turn it over very much, and that's already five. 15-6, 12-11 to play in the first half. J.J. Twy gets a ball screen from Lawrence Wright. Now it's Ray Brown. We'll have an official time in the next dead ball. With it on the left. Get a ball screen is Jeremy Crouch. Bounce pass is Boogie. Had Sam Singh open for a moment. With it is Twy, who hasn't scored yet this year. Ray Brown with 18-17 on the shot clock. Looks for a skip pass. Gives it to J.J. inside Crouch. Lay it up, and before on the floor, he was fouled. And it'll be inbound when we come back. Jeremy made the shot, but it won't count. 13 foul for Delaware State. 11:49 to play first half. Bradley with the ball and a new shot clock. It's Bradley 15, Delaware State 6. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD. You got any scores, Courtney? I think Illinois State and Cal Northridge. Let's see. Drake and San Jose State. That game should be final. Okay.
On your mark, get set, go.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sableback at Carver Arena in downtown Peoria. Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by Avanti's. If you have a son or daughter between 8 and 12, register them to be an honorary ball boy or ball girl at any of the three Avanti's locations. Winners will be notified and announced prior to each home game. And Bradley basketball is brought to you by the country insurance and financial agents of the game. Tonight they're Ron Rimmel, Jim Carlson, the former coach, and Jason Milan in Peoria. Well, the Braves are opening up a little bit. Coach, 5 of 8 from the field, 3 of 3 from 3, 2 of 2 from the line on boogies.
Well, it's
rebounds are even at 3. There won't be many of those tonight.
No, it's 4 to 4, Dave, at the 4-minute mark, and we're 3 out of 3 from 3-point range since then. That opened it up.
lined up in front of Jeremy Crouch. Sam Singh boogies out on the in the paint at this point. J.J. Twy and Ray Brown. Bradley has essentially their second team on the floor with the exception of Lawrence Wright, and he could be a second teamer when O'Brien comes back. We will see. That's going to be an interesting decision. 11:49 to play first half. Bradley 15, Delaware State 6. And there's the second horn, and we'll get ready to go. A new shot clock after the foul. Count is 2, the count is 3, and a bounce pass is J.J. Twine. Give it back to Crouch. 3 ball right. That bounce is no good. Had an open jumper and couldn't hit it from the corner on the right as he continues to struggle from the field. He's now 2 of 20, or 5 of 28 from three-point range. And so here come the Hornets to run more clock. Brad Fleetwood with it. And a handoff is to Walker. He's out near the timeline with a left-hand dribble. Works against J.J. Twy. Looks to get a ball screen, but J.J. forces him left. He brings it on top. Fleetwood with it. Shot clock reads 8. Now 7. Now 6. Looking to move is Blunt with 5. Ray Brown stops him with 4. Ball knocked away. Boogie with 3. There's going to be a violation. Good Bradley defense by Ray Brown and Lawrence Wright in the 6th turnover at 11:08 for the first half. Bradley 15, Delaware State 6. Lawrence Wright inbounds to J.J. Twy. We'll update the scoreboard. Drake won in the Valley at San Jose State tonight. 9 minutes into this one. Jeremy Crouch on the left. Now a pass too hard to handle. Great hands by Singh, who puts it up and walked.
That's too bad. It was
great hands by Sam. Is right. A tough pass for Lawrence Wright to get to him, and he caught it. I don't know how he caught it.
Looks like it was going out of bounds.
Here's Joe Dickens back in, and he replaces Blunt.
Only 2 fouls on Bradley again, and we fell down to 3 baskets.
Sam did walk. There was no doubt about that. Here's Bush look to inbound, and does to Dickens. He'll bring it up across the timeline and get out the hourglass again, because here comes our offensive set. Look how they've got the floor spread, Coach. They've got almost the 4 corners.
See, Sam, for good team defense, Sam's about 8 feet off of it. It's a lot more difficult for a bigger player out there.
Good help by Crouch, and here's a jumper for 3, bouncing no good. Rebound is tipped off 3 hands. Jeremy dives for the ball, but it's picked up by Delaware State. Everybody went for the ball that time, and 2 Braves collided, and the Hornets wound up with it. The new shot clock, which is already down to 25. 10:22 for the first half. Bradley 15, Delaware State 6. With it left is Dickens. Pass
nice
downstairs,
pass.
And a layup is up and good. Nicely done. As Worley got the field goal, and it's 15-8, his first deuce. Coming up on the halfway mark of the first half, Bradley's lead is 7, and we have 10 minutes to go in the first frame. With it, Ray Brown, fake left. Now hold it, give it to Singh, look for the drop-down pass. Sam got a man in the air, finds Lawrence Wright for the layup is good from Sam Singh. 3 Braves are coming in, Ruffin, Andrews, and Somerville. 4 points for Boogie, and it's a 17-8 Bradley lead. Almost a cut down to the passing lane. The count is on. Singh was on Roundtree downstairs. Here's a shot crotched and missed by Blunt. And the rebound taken down by the Braves. And here comes J.J. Twy across the timeline. Gives to Singh. Sam put it on the floor twice. Throws a pass that's hauled down by Crouch. Baseline drive back to Lawrence Wright. Now Ray Brown. J.J., get your first field goal. Missed it. Rebound on the offensive glasses. Boogie put up the shot. Missed. Try to reverse layup, couldn't get enough oomph on it. Down quickly at the other end, here comes Darren Shine, who's back in for Delaware State. It's Shine and Blunt, along with Bush. We've got a whole new crew in there. And Worley. Now Shine backs up, he's gonna go one-on-one against J.J. Kicks it off Worley, his lean-in jumper, bounce no good. Rebound is tipped off 3 hands. Loose on the floor, picked up by Twy, and J.J. gets the outlet pass to Ray Brown. He went to the floor and gave it to him. Brown, Twy, Jeremy, 3 ball left, missed. Rebound is taken down, Lawrence Wright on the offensive glass again. To J.J. Twy, Ray Brown's 3 ball right, that's missed. As the Braves just can't get a 3-point shot down from anywhere they fire him. 3 of 7 now after being 3 of 3, and Bennett will come in the next dead ball. 17-8. Bradley lead is 9, and here we'll run some more clock. With it is Dickens. Free throw line extended on the right. look for the outlet and doesn't get. And there's a whistle. Is Ray Brown going to get a foul? We'll see.
Maybe Sam.
Sing away from play. Yep, 5-4. Hold. Sam's first. Bradley's starting lineup will come back in with Wright staying on the floor. So the second team did an admirable job there. Well, they couldn't hit the three balls from Crouch or Brown. Inbound sideline right is Dickens. Gives to... Well, Dickens holds the ball himself now to Worley. Behind the back, he drives all the way down. And Blunt loses it out of bounds. 7:48 on the seventh turnover of the first half. It's Bradley 17, Delaware State 8. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois. Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, and Jim Watson back at Carver Arena. Our scores from the Valley will give you real quick that we have. 15-11 to go in the first half. Northern Iowa at Cedar Falls leading 15-7. Evansville 14, Campbell 11 at 14-57. 16-44, Wichita at Missouri, Kansas City leading 7-4. Illinois State starts at Cal Northridge later. Indiana State beat Butler 59-58 at the buzzer, and Drake 84, San Jose State 64. 82-64 was the final in that one. Bradley Braves basketball brought to you by CDS Office Systems. Revolutionize your office with a new Konica Minolta Biz Hub from CDS Technology. CDS, they connect people. What are the numbers show, Coach?
Well, the last 4 minutes, Dave, each team had a basket. It was 2-2 the last 4 minutes.
Oh, that's... Boy, I'll tell you. But that's the way they have to play, the Hornets do. They have to slow it down to try to limit the possessions. We heard that from Dennis Jones in the pregame show, but the most enjoyable thing to watch.
Well, it's a little hard to play against, too, Dave. You're on defense most of the time. They've had the ball more than we have. We've just done a better job of it.
Ruffin, bring the ball up high to the right. They double out of it, out of their timeout. Somerville, give Tony Bennett on the bounce pass. Tony's three ball left is bouncing no good. Another rebound by Lawrence right on the offensive boards. Hooks it in, Zach Andrews, kaboom!
That's nice recognition by Lawrence that time, too.
And the 12th dunk of the year, and there's no doubt about when he gets the ball in that position. He's going to dunk it 19-8. 12th dunk of the year. Worley a ball fake. Now he fires a three up. That's an air ball, and it's out of bounds. 19-8 is the Bradley lead. That's 7-11 to go in the first half. Here comes Elon Bush. No, they're going to go with Phillip Brown. So they've used them all now, except Rocky Meiji. We're looking forward to Rocky coming in. 7:05 to play. I bet we see before it's over. Somerville. Free throw line extended on the left. Ooh, a telegraph pass, and Boogie got away with it. Give to Somerville left. His three ball looks good. Bounce it, no good. Tony Bennett skies to the rebound, and it goes off his hands out of bounds.
Lawrence is doing a better job of finding the open man on some of his drives now, Dave. He's made several good passes in the last couple games.
6:53 to play first half. Bradley 19, Delaware State 8. I think they'll get to 20 in the first half. There's a five-second count as denial on an inbounds pass. And Elon Bush commits the eighth turnover. Couldn't get it inbounds in time. So the Braves will trigger. Baseline left. Here comes Aaron Fleetwood in. And hitting the bench will be Joe Dickens. Bennett with the inbounds. Ruffin up high right. Skip pass left. Somerville looking to post pass. Another skip is Ruff. Up top is Lawrence Wright. A step by Somerville. Cross court lob is Bennett. Inside Lawrence Wright. He walks. He was three-timed through the ball in the middle of the zone. Fourth Bradley turnover. 6:37 to play, first half. Bradley 19, Delaware State 8. Ooh, they're on the run in the front court.
Well, they run down to here. Now they're going to slow
it down. But they're going to slow it down again. Shine with it. I thought just maybe. Here's a post pass knocked away by Tony Bennett. And off the leg, out of bounds. Tony, a fine defensive play. Swatted it off the leg of Blunt. The ninth turnover for Delaware State. Think they'll get to 20 by halftime, Coach?
Well, you got to get to 10 first, David. Should make that.
Ruffin, Bennett, free throw line extended on the left. Zach Andrews at the high post is mugged and fouled. Fourth team foul. First foul
on Darren Shine.
Darren Shine, his first. Bradley has three team fouls. This game should go quickly, though, because we're not going to shoot many free throws with him playing like this.
With a two-shot by total the whole game so far. We played 14 minutes.
That was the first 2 points of the game, remember, when Boogie hit him. Here's Bennett with it, left. There's Ruffin, a ball fake. Look inside, now he's going to drive. Lob inside, Zach Andrews, kaboom! From Ruffin. Second dunk of the night.
Well, Zach's percentage on the year, Dave, is going to be real good because he don't take many bad shots. He's taking
it's hard to miss
right
that
at,
one.
Right at the basket.
21-8 as Andrews got his third field goal. 6 points. The count is three. The count is four. And a whip pass at the other end. And they got a breakaway. And a layup is good as Andrews just let Blunt go. And he got the layup. So they got the 10, Coach. 21-10. 5:34 to play first half. Here's Zach at the other end. His layup is missed. Tipped by Boogie. Get it back. Lay it up and get it. Lawrence Wright went to the offensive boards. The Braves are really crashing him again tonight. 6 points for Lawrence Wright. 12 points of the 23 from the junior college from Yuba. 13-point Bradley lead with 5:13 to play in a half. 23-10. With it, Shine. I could give commercials during their possessions. Shine with it. Gets doubled. Inside pass. There's a charge. Yep, taken by Tony Bennett. As Elon Bush ran right into him.
Taking a lot of charges already this year, Dave. It's good to see that.
10th turnover, 5th team foul, 2nd foul on Bush. And with 5 minutes to play in the half, it's a 13-point Bradley lead. Bennett with it, look for a ball fake. Give it to Ruffin. Look for the post pass. Ruff, penetrate, give it to Bennett. Tony give to Somerville. Look for a ball screen instead, it's right. Now it's Ruffin. Wide open, Zach Andrews, a step, and walked. He dunked it. But he walked first, and there was no doubt about it. Bradley's 5th turnover. Coach Zach, he could have a kaboom counter of his own.
Well, I tell you, Dave, it's going to be interesting to see what he shoots on the season because he don't take any bad shots, and he's an awfully good offensive rebounder.
Here's an entry pass is made. They've got a bit of a break, 3-on-2. Bounce pass at the other end. The shot is blocked by Lawrence Wright as he blocked the layup. And then the ball's thrown away by Ruffin and tipped in the backcourt back on the 6th turnover. Braves got a little bit too out of control that time. Shine at the other end, 10-footer good.
Shine.
23-12, Shine has 4. Here's Ruffin, give to Bennett. Looks at Zach Andrews posting inside. Lawrence Wright is right there. Here's a 3-ball Ruffin corner right. That bounce is no good. Somerville layup good on the offensive board. He's got 8.
Really dominating on the boards, Dave.
25-12. The rebounds are 12-8, and that's a lot because there aren't many shots. Shine with it.
Well, the ones we're getting, a lot of them going up as putbacks, too.
Roundtree is back in. Here's a drive to the baseline. Stopped is Fleetwood, and he hits the shot and a foul on the shot. And they'll shoot free throws when we come back. Fleetwood hits a turnaround 10-footer and was fouled on the play. And Zach Andrews picked up his 2nd foul. And Will Franklin will make his Bradley debut, number 4, when we come back in a minute. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD.
to go, Coach.
Thank you.
Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sable back at Carver Arena. Four offensive rebounds already for Lawrence Wright out of Bradley's five. Somerville had the other one a moment ago. Bradley Braves basketball brought to you by Paradise. Go to Las Vegas this February for the big game party courtesy of Paradise Hotel Casino. Prime reward members earn entries through January 15th with slot table game play and double entries on Mondays. Paradise Hotel Casino halftime report coming up. Bradley Braves basketball is brought to you by Methodist. Team up with Methodist for outstanding health care that's centered on you. Methodist is proud to be the official health care provider for Bradley basketball. Coach, not really any surprise what we're seeing here tonight.
No, Dave, we're both teams are shooting about the same, shooting about 46%, but we're getting more shots. We're just hurting them on the boards. And when we get an offensive rebound, it's generally going back in the basket.
Our next broadcast will be in Hattiesburg, Mississippi on Wednesday night. Bradley and Southern Miss. Andy Oreo at 6 o'clock with Braves Plus. Will Franklin, Houston, Texas, Kilgore. 3.5 points, one rebound. And Will gets a nice hand. Welcome, Will. After serving the suspension. Go into that politically, but leave it alone. The Braves are doing quite well. They've developed some depth. Three-point opportunity coming up here for Fleetwood. 25-14, trying to cut it to 10, and does. But their first make of the night it is. 5 points for Fleetwood. 25-15, the Bradley lead is 10.
They're showing a little bit of a trap here now.
Here's Crouch across the timeline and try to get a bounce pass to Somerville. It was kicked out of bounds. 27 on the shot clock. 3:39 to play first half. Bradley 25, Delaware State 15. Crouch inbound sideline left to Franklin. And we'll attack here and run. They try to double him, give it to Bennett. Now Somerville, a ball fake, didn't take. Bennett looks to penetrate, got a skip pass for Jeremy. Get in there, Jeremy! Bounce it, no good. Rebound again, Lawrence Wright. That's number six. Inside out to Crouch, a ball fake. He didn't shoot it. He was open, didn't shoot it that time. Now Bennett with a new shot clock, of course. Crouch with it. Going to drive this time all the way down, lay it up, and flip it in. Crouch took the drive that time and gets his first deuce, 27-15. 3:03 to play in the half. The Bradley lead is 12. Bradley 27, Delaware State 15. With it is Shine. He's trying to negotiate traffic. Will Franklin is on him. Count was on, count was three, count was four, and he barely got it away in time. Fleetwood with it, put it on the floor and give to Philip Brown, who touched it really in the first time of their offense. Drive baseline all the way down, layup is good as Boogie was beaten badly that time as Roundtree got the field goal. His second, he's got four, 27-17. 10-point Bradley lead with 2.5 to play. Well, Boogie was wide open and Crouch didn't see him. Bennett. Skip passes to Crouch to the baseline. Nice entry pass, Somerville. 10-footer good.
Nice pass to Jeremy. They cut him off in the baseline. Good pass.
Double figures for Somerville. 10, 29, 17. The Bradley lead is 12 with 2:10 to play in the half. With it is Shine. Left, right. Left hand dribble. Lose it a minute. Now come to the right. Here's Phillip Brown. Brown. Lawrence Wright has played a terrific first half. With it is Roundtree. His jumper from way out misses. Ball is rebounded long by Fleetwood. It was about to go out of bounds. Ray Brown will come in the next dead ball with a minute 47 to go in the half. And the shot clock reloaded and counting down at 25. Beat a man a half a step on a block-to-block pass. Stepping in and kick it back out for a jumper. Long range as Brown missed it. Rebound is Will Franklin. And he's fouled. Gets his first number. As a Bradley Brave, it's a rebound. 29-17, six-team foul with a minute 34 to play. Possession arrow belongs to Delaware State. Bennett comes out, Brown is in. Lawrence Wright rebounding in the first half has six. I think they're all offensive. With it, Franklin, Brown, A back screen by Somerville. Here's Lawrence Wright, inside out Ray. Give it Somerville, three ball left corner. Hits the side of the rim. Rebound comes down to Ray Brown, who flips it in the air and gets it back. Crouch, three ball right. Bounce it, no good. It's all in his head now, Coach, I'm afraid. 29-17.
It must be, because he's a good shooter.
Shine has it taken away, Somerville. And then it's taken back by Shines as he got him from behind. Now that is quick. You strip me, I'll strip you. That's what happened that time. Under a minute to play in the half. Still 29-17, Bradley. With it, stepping in and turning it over is a Darren Shine. Turnover number 12. And Jim Less wants his first half timeout with 53.2 to go in the first frame. And the Bradley lead is 29-17. Don't think they're going to get to 20, Coach, unless they throw a three ball in.
Well, that might happen. We've shot two free throws. We're 2-for-2. They're 1-for-1, Dave.
Bradley Braves basketball brought to you by Watson I, one of our favorite hangouts, Buffalo Wild Wings. The next 1470 WMBD Bradley tailgate party is Wednesday, the 28th, from 4:30 to 7 at Buffalo Wild Wings in East Peoria before the Northern Iowa game. Register for the conference tournament in St. Louis, including trip and accommodations. 53.2 to go in the first half. Bradley 29, Delaware State 17. Lawrence Wright will inbound. It's Wright, Franklin, Somerville, and Ray Brown.
Let Franklin play the point a little now against the zone.
2-3 zone, and then looked a trap out of it at the timeline. Trying to speed the Braves up a little bit. Will pulls down a pass from Somerville on a skip. Here's Wright, Crouch, Franklin. Looks down to the baseline, gives to Somerville. Is that his first assist? Nope. Ray Brown tips once, twice.
Nice pass.
And out of bounds to inbounds. It'll go to the Braves with 34.7. And now they can use the shot clock for the last shot of the half if they want it. That should have been a layup. Inbound right. Underneath the Bradley goal baseline, right, Franklin against the 2-3 zone. Looks at Somerville, looks at Lawrence Wright, gives it to him for a layup, and there's his first assist off the inbounds pass. 31-17, 8 points for Lawrence Wright. And let's see if they go for one shot. They might as well. With it, a ball fake by Fleetwood. Gives to Shine with 17 seconds. Bradley 31, Delaware State 17, 13 seconds. Shine with it, want to get a ball screen. They double him and now look to rotate. Shine with it between the rings with 8, now 7, down with 6. They double with 5. Inside out, here's Roundtree, shot for 3, bounce it, no good. Rebound tip, no good, and that's halftime. They didn't get to 20. 31-17 is Bradley's lead at halftime over Delaware State. 14 points at this pace is like 28. And the Braves lead it by 14. The Paradise Hotel Casino halftime report is coming your way in a minute. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on 1470 WMBD.
Well, they're easy to do in the stats, Dave.
Won't take long, will it? Here you go, Coach.
That drive by Crouch is the only basket we had out of except four guys.
I know.
Three and 12. He just can't make a shot.
Welcome back to Carver Arena, everybody, and the Paradise Hotel Casino halftime report. December's forecast calls for 13 days of cash flurries at Paradise Hotel Casino. It's your chance to win cash and lots of it as they draw for $35,000 December 11th through the 23rd. Visit Paradise for your share of cash flurries. The second half possession will belong to Delaware State. As Bradley leads 31-17, Coach, it won't take you too long to go down the scoring for the first half.
And now, Dave, and Bradley only had, other than their starters, the only best they had was by Crouch. We'll go with Bradley first. Somerville, 4 out of 8, 2 of those to 3-point range. He had 3 rebounds for his 10 points. Played 16 minutes. Zach Andrews, 3 out of 4 with a rebound, 6 points for Zach. Lawrence Wright had one of his better first halves, I think, Dave. He's 3 out of 4 from the field, 2 out of 2 from the free throw line. He had 5 offensive rebounds. Their team had 3. He ended up a total of 6 rebounds. He had 3 assists. He made several nice passes as well. 1 block and 1 steal, and a real good first half.
He's
by
played
Lawrence.
A wonderful game, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. Tony Bennett was 2 out of 4. One of those, a 3. 5 points for Tony. Danny Ruffin only took 2 shots, did not score in the first half, but did have 2 steals and also 2 assists. No turnovers, 10 minutes for Daniel. Ray Brown played briefly, had 2 rebounds, did not score. Will Franco played briefly and made a couple nice passes. I don't think Will is going to be the type of guy that's going to take many bad shots. I think he's more of a setup type player, which you really like to have your point guard be. J.J. Dry did not score in 6 minutes, made several good passes. Jeremy Crouch, 1 out of 5 from the field. Unfortunately, Jeremy not hitting that 3-point shot yet. He certainly can, he just hasn't done it. And Sam Singh played briefly, did not score for the half. Bradley shot 45%, going 13 of 29. Only 3 out of 13 from 3-point range. Made both the free throws they shot. They out-rebounded Delaware State 16 to 11. For the half, they shot 45%, 23 from 3, and made their only 2 free throws.
And for the Hornets, Coach, not much sting.
No, just, well, they take so long to get in their offense, Dave, and we're doing a real good job on them defensively. I think we've done, not just the fact we held down their score, but we probably had 5 second counts on them, which is another indication that you're doing a good job of shutting down the passing lanes. For they had Fleetwood with 2 out of 3 from the field, made his only free throw. He also had 5 rebounds to lead them in rebound and lead them in scoring with 5 points. I tell you, leading scorer's got 5 points, you're not going to have a lot as a rule. Joe Dickens played 11 minutes, did not score. Troy Rontree was 2 out of 4 for his 4. Darren Shines appears to be a pretty good little ball handler out there. He was 2 out of 2 from the field for his 4. Tracy Worley had a basket for 2, and off the bench, Joshua Blunt had 1 out of 3 for 2 points. They shot 42% from the field, rebounded 3 offensive rebounds for the whole half for them. And for the game, they made their only free throw.
Halftime score as the old Bud Light Daredevils, I don't know what they're called now, are performing at halftime. Bradley 31, Delaware State 17. The Hornets will have possession to open the second half. We'll take our 5-minute break and be back with frame number 2. This is on the Paradise Hotel Casino Halftime Report. Bradley Braves basketball on 1470 WMBD.
I don't think that was part of the act, Coach.
Pardon?
The guy losing his pants. I don't think that was part of the act.
Oh, yeah.
It is?
Oh, yeah. No doubt about it. Hey, that's pretty good. The guy be able to hold him up his hands that long. That's pretty good.
Of course, we all could do that, too, if that's all we had to do all day. Get a nice sponsor.
I don't think I could do that.
Welcome back, everybody, to Carver Arena and the Paradise Hotel Casino Halftime Report. Bradley 31, Delaware State 17. Coach, what can you learn about a game like this? I mean, we probably are not going to see much like this the rest of the season as far as tempo is concerned. We might see it on Wednesday night because that's a team that doesn't score very much either.
No, and you might see it, at Indiana State, places like that. One thing I'd like to see, Dave, when playing against a team like that, we get out and with our big players and really play good defense in the perimeter, which you got to do. If you got a weak player, they'll put him out on the point, and you have a hard time guarding. So I think when we play against a team like this, we are a kind of team that can take advantage of it. And I think that, the 5 second counts we've had, the good job of double teams, the trapping, I think, we do that a very good job of that.
Yeah. Bradley and Mississippi State, I was looking at some of their scores. They had 35 in one game. They struggled to score. And they have, I think on their roster, I looked today, I think they have maybe 5 or 6 junior college players.
Well, the coach they brought in last year, Dave.
Larry Stacy.
Yeah, he was big in getting junior college players. He evidently hasn't got the quality yet that he likes, but he'll get that program going.
He was at Iowa State, remember, and they lost to Hampton in the NCAA. That was one of the big upsets of that tournament that year. Well, we're about 4 minutes away from the start of the second half.
Another thing you're going to see, Dave, is interesting. This may bring out the best in Lawrence Wright, because, you know, the starting lineup is yet to be determined when we get the big guy back and we get Patrick back. And
somebody's going to sit.
A good player is going to sit. The way Lawrence is playing tonight, he's had a sensational game, and the way that Zach has played ever since he got a chance to start, you know, he's been outstanding. So it gives you good depth certainly.
Yeah, that's going to be an interesting one for Jim to deal with, but you'd rather have it that way than not have enough.
Well, you know, and Zach seems to be like type of person is not going to bother him whether he comes off the bench or starts or not. You know, he's just going to come in and play hard, and he's going to be effective. The only time he's going to be outside the low block, you know, he'll be screaming away or off the high post or maybe at a wing, but he's very content to play inside, and it's a good thing because he plays there very well, and he's really got a nose for the ball.
That's our Paradise Hotel Casino halftime report. The Braves are back on the floor. They will move, as we call the action, from right to left in the second half. Bradley 31, Delaware State 17. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD. Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sable back for the second half. Jeff Lohman is here and has said that 30 years ago today, Coach Stoll, your team at Robertson Fieldhouse beat Detroit. Terry Tyler, John Long.
And then Dick Vitale was coaching.
And Dick Vitale was coaching. That game was 30 years ago today. See, Jeff and Joe D'Alfonso, the three historians here, providing that. That was a big win, Coach. Dennis Smith played very well in that game, if I remember.
Yeah, Dennis came in and got a few bats for us. It was a good game, and of course, Dick always had something to say.
But still does.
Well, he didn't have too much to say after that game.
No, he didn't. He came in my office, was very upset. I was sports information director at that time. Dick Vitale, Coach, when he is on, he helps me exercise one bit of video equipment.
That's the mute button, right? Well, yeah, you may. I don't know if you remember that in the game or not, but I think it was Marcel D'Souza who got a basket about the last 5 seconds to win the game.
The game, Marcel D'Souza. We were just talking about it. And how is Marcel? You talked to him?
Yeah, he's doing fine. He's a baby doctor down in San Paulo, still coaching the club team, and slim chance he might have a chance to become the Olympic coach sometime. I'd certainly like to see that happen.
Boy, that'd be great. Like his mentor, for sure. 31-17 is the Bradley lead at halftime. Delaware State will have possession to open up the second half. And Jim will probably go with the starters. Once again, we'll have to see what Delaware State will do. Bradley and Southern Mississippi from Hattiesburg, Mississippi, on Wednesday night.
One thing they're probably going to do is the same thing, Dave. I don't like to see them play a great deal different. They're going to have a difficult time. When you play slow, you're going to have a difficult time playing a fast team like Bradley, and they had 12 turnovers the first half. That's about what they average a game.
Bradley Braves basketball on WMBD, Peoria, Illinois. And so everybody gets to their feet, and we'll get ready to start the second half.
And they're going to stay on their feet, supposedly, Dave, until Delaware State scores, which could be any time or no time.
I remember that one year at Wichita, Carr, Livingston, all that group, and a Bradley team had them standing for 10 minutes. in the second half. That was third kill, and Reese and Anderson. And Garrick Duhart was on that team.
Good team.
Inbounds pass thrown in the backcourt to Darren Shine, and here we go with half number two. Ruffin's on him. It is Shine Fleetwood. And it looks like they have their starters with Roundtree in there and Worley. Here's a bounce pass. No, Blunt is in instead. And here's an entry pass is made and sets everybody down quickly. As Fleetwood gets the field goal, he's got seven, 31-19. So the first score of the second half goes to the Hornets. Ruffin with it, gives Somerville. Free throw line extended left, bad pass. As fronting the post that time was Dickens. Eighth Bradley turnover, goes behind the back in the lane. Stop and blocked, and a jump ball as Zach Andrews gets the block and the jump, and he was falling away when he did it.
You don't want to go in the paint weak when you had Zach in there.
Jaws got another one, 31-19 in the Bradley second possession. On the first one was taken away on a post pass. Here's Ruff with it between the legs across the timeline with a left and the right-hand dribble, brings it to the right. Entry pass, Zach Andrews. Ball is snapped on the floor. It's loose on the floor. It's a held ball. It's a jump ball again. In the first 50 seconds of the second half, there have been two changes in possession arrows. That'll be a turnover, number nine for the Braves. 19-10 to play. And Roundtree will inbound, and Bradley will show backcourt pressure. Shines is back there, and so is Blunt. They had an open baseball pass to Shines, but instead Roundtree comes back, or make it Fleetwood, to give it to him. So Shines across the timeline with 1 minute into the second half.
Pretty good little ball handler, Shines.
Works to Ruffin. Here's a pull-up jumper for three. It's bounced away no good, and Summer, or making Andrews, gets the rebound.
That surprised everybody.
As Blunt missed a shot, a wild shot. Here's Somerville's three missed. Rebound taken down long. Blunt, and he's on the move. At the other end, a lob. Kaboom! Thrown down by Joshua Blunt on a two-on-one break.
Fine pass by Shine.
31-21. And now Coach Les is not happy. And we'll have a full timeout here, and we will take a break as well. 18:35 to play, and Coach Les is going to... all right, fellas, let's come out and play. It's been a little sloppy on the half court with some lazy passes. 31-21. You're listening to Bradley Braves basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois. Jim Les uses his first timeout in the second half at 18:35. Somerville, Ruffin, Bennett, Wright, and Andrews on the floor as it's a 31-21 game. Halftime lead was 31-17. So they finally did get to 20. Bradley assisted turnover now is 10-9, up and down. Braves at Southern Mississippi, and then we'll welcome Patrick O'Brien back as the Braves on the 28th will play preseason Valley favorite Northern Iowa Panthers.
Still playing a matchup zone here, Dave.
Ruffin with it across the timeline. Ruff's had a good four game tonight. They looked a double out of it. Somerville throws a skip pass Bennett. Fakes left, comes right. Ooh, they wanted to go back door to Lawrence Wright, and he was open a bit, but not enough. Somerville with it, 18 on the shot clock. Bennett with it, gets a ball screen. Pull up 12-footer, Tony missed. In and out, there's another tip in by... a shot by Wright on an offensive rebound, and he was fouled. Let's see if he goes up for two free throws. Roundtree picked it up. Yeah, and remember, the first 2 points of the first half were scored by Lawrence Wright at the free throw line. The first 2 points of the second half could come at the free throw line from Lawrence Wright. He has 8 points. That, by the way, were the only two free throws, and the first one misses. Shot on the first half for Bradley. One more for Wright, still 31-21 with 18:15 to play. See if they pressure on a make. Here's the make. Here's the pressure. Roundtree will inbound. Slaps and looks at Fleetwood instead.
Zone press.
Gives to Dickens. He's trapped. It's taken away by Lawrence Wright. All the way down. Flip it up and bounce it in.
And I think he may have been fouled, Dave.
Backdoor three-point play off the steal. 34-21. Lawrence Wright has 11. Fake of the pass. Is Roundtree and gives to Shine out of Roundtree across the timeline. He's a big guy, so he won't be handling it much. 17:48 to play for the game. Bradley 34, Delaware State 21. Here's a three ball. That's a quick three. Bounce away, no good as Blunt missed it. Rebound as outlet pass is to Somerville from Ruffin. Puts up the shot and fouled. And that is already the second team foul at 17:38. And Somerville will go to the line for a pair.
Well, they take it down and take a quick shot, Dave, and we're able to get back in transition on them. They got a good shot. Good pass from Ruffin.
I couldn't believe they took that shot. Neither could Greg Jackson. Look at him. He's having a bad night. Somerville double figures 10. Now 11. He has 11. Lawrence Wright has 11. 35-21. Bradley's lead is 14. It'll be the biggest if he makes this, and he did. 36-21. Roundtree inbounds again. Gives it Fleetwood and now Shines. Takes a look at his options and blunts across the timeline. Almost knocked away by Tony Bennett, who goes crawling across the floor. Here's Fleetwood. Give to Roundtree. His layup is good as he got through around Zach Andrews.
He's fairly effective around the basket.
He has 6, 36-23, back to a 13-point Bradley lead. Here's Lawrence Wright all the way to the basket. Flip it up and miss it, but fouled. I think he wanted to try to dunk that from about 10 feet in and was fouled. He pulled up maybe about 8 feet away. Third foul on Roundtree. And that's the third team foul, and Lawrence Wright back to the free throw line. He has 11 points. Bradley 5 of 6 from the line. He's 3 of 4, and the free throw's good. Biggest lead now, a 37-23. Just into the second half, Northern Iowa 37, Florida A&M 24. Wichita 37, Missouri Kansas City 29, just starting the second half. At halftime, Evansville 42, Campbell 38. Second free throw is good. Valley pitching a shutout today. Fleetwood from Roundtree gives to Shine. 38-23, the Bradley lead is 15. With it on the break, Blunt looks in, now comes back out. Here's Roundtree with it. They're doing a lot of one-on-one now. Here's a wild shot missed. Rebound taken by Ruffin Long, and the ball is kicked out of bounds. As Bennett and Ruffin were too close together, Pete Vanacken on the old scoreboard tonight. Pete, back from Florida, looking good. Ruffin almost an inbound steal against Shine. He gets away, and now we'll run their offense. It's been a little bit more put it up oriented here in the second half. Fleetwood and now Shine. He has it on the left. Roundtree with it 10 feet away. He's going to go in the lane against Somerville. Tough shot, missed it. Rebound is Lawrence Wright. Another one. He's fouled, but then he picks it up, tries to get away, and throws it away to Somerville. It was the intended receiver, but it was knocked out of bounds by Fleetwood. I'll tell you what, Lawrence Wright is all over the floor just like Zach was the other night. He's in the middle of everything. He's got 8 rebounds, so he's on his way to a double-double. 16:33 to play. Bradley 38, Delaware State 23. Our magic number was 60, and Delaware State might have to play 2 games to get there. With it is Ruffin. Just to the right of straightaway. Looks at Zach Andrews on a lob, and there's a hold as Roundtree held Zach, who went back door and may have been intended to get a lob. Fourth foul on Roundtree, and he's about to get the shaft. The elevator shaft. Alan Walker comes in, and Roundtree comes out. He's got a good beard, though, Coach.
He may be 30, Dave.
He does look old. With it is Bennett. Now it's Wright, Ruffin. Somerville, is he going to go baseline? He's going to get a ball screen. I got a dunk coming here from Zach here in a little bit. Here's a pull-up jumper from 17 by Somerville. Misses. And the rebound taken down by the Hornets. And they're on the move across the timeline. With it, Worley all the way down. Lay up and get it. 38-25. Worley has four. Ruffin, Bennett, Tony, lob inside is Zach Andrews. Feels the double and somebody's open. Tries to dribble out of it. Bounce passes Bennett. Turns and gets away. Ruffin, Somerville. Sellis takes it in the lane. Try to drop down pass and Zach wasn't there. 11th Bradley turnover. Here comes Shine all the way down. Penetrate and kick for a three ball. Blunt in and out. Rebound taken down Somerville. Braves have numbers if they want him. Instead he just hands to his Peoria Central teammate, Ruffin. And Somerville was open for a three, didn't take it. Has it on the left wing. And it's out of bounds at 15:23. We'll have an official time. Crouches in, 15:23. Bradley with the ball and 24 on the shot clock. When we come back in a minute, it's Bradley 38, Delaware State 25. You're listening to Bradley Basketball at 1470 WMBD. Uh-oh, that's a turnover.
15.
That's called a handicap there. I think he's done, Coach.
5 seconds.
Okay, take it and throw it. That probably cost him, didn't it?
I don't know what we give him.
When you have a team effort with people working together,
Bradley Braves Basketball brought to you by Methodist. Team up with Methodist for outstanding health care that's centered on you. Methodist is proud to be the official health care provider for Bradley Braves Basketball. And a place Coach Stoll and I will be seeing this week, the Greater Peoria Airport. This winter, your escape starts at the Greater Peoria Airport. Where in the world do you want to go? Flights to Vegas, Orlando are all wonderful. Or New Orleans to go to Hattiesburg, Mississippi. Wherever you want to go, call your travel agent. 43% for the Braves in the field, 13 of 30. Is that right? Or did I look at the wrong page again?
14-33, I believe, Dave.
I had to give it. 14-33, 42%, 41 for Delaware State. They're 12 of 29. They're 0 of 8 from 3.
Well, we've been hounding them pretty good, Dave. We're putting a lot of pressure on the ball.
Crouch replaces Lawrence Wright for the Braves.
Lawrence Wright is out. Jeremy Crouch is in. Looks like a matchup zone again, a 3-2.
Yeah,
they're matching up out of it. A lob out of the huddle. Come on, Tony Bennett from Ruffin.
Well, you'll have that sometime, Dave, against the zone. He did a good job of execution.
40-25. The Bradley lead is 15. That was a play called Hawk that has run out of the huddle for the backdoor dunk, and that's what it was that time. 7 for Bennett. With it is Dickens. He drives against Somerville. Penetrate and kick. And Shine had to go get it with 15:14 on the shot clock. 14:49 to play for the game.
Nice
pass inside. Beautiful pass. Scored Worley from Shine. He's got 6. That was a great pass.
Shine's a good player.
40-27. The Bradley lead is 13. With it is Bennett. Look at Zach Andrews. Get a ball screen for Tony. Looks and gives a skip pass to Ruffin. Now it's Andrews going to drive. Penetrate and kick Bennett. Crouch. Ruffin. Got a man in the air, pull up, 12-footer, that's good, his first two. 42-27, nice little ball fake. Got the man off his feet, put it in. Bradley's lead is 15 again with 14-12 to play for the game. With it is Josh Blunt. Well, they ran the half-court offense very well the last time. Worley with it, out near the timeline, and crouches on him with 20 on the shot clock. With it is Roundtree. Or Fleetwood, rather, and he stepped on the sideline out of bounds on the right. Ray Brown is in, and he replaces Tony Bennett. J.J. Twy will come in for Ruffin.
And they took out Chine, Dave. Their offense runs much better with Chine in the ball game. He's a very good passer, very good ball handler.
So it could bog down a little now.
Yeah.
And it's not exactly running like a new car at your local Ford dealer. 42-27, Crouch with it, J.J. Twy. Brown, can't say enough about how JJ has played at the point with Will Franklin's suspension. With it, Brown. Somerville comes out, high left. He's going to drive, penetrate and kick. Give it to JJ Twy for a three ball for Jeremy Crouch. Somebody say!
Hallelujah. Nice penetration that time by Twy as well.
JC has five as he got the three ball down. 45-27, it's an 18-point Bradley lead with 13-20 to play. Here's Worley. Post pass is given to Blunt. His jumper missed. Weak side rebound off three hands. Blocked by Zach, who plants Worley and fouled Worley. That's a third foul on Zach Andrews at 13-14. Braves are about to go to 5-2 and to Mississippi.
Good to see Crouch get one of those series in, Dave. And, you know, we're coming into the conference schedule now. He surely could be a big asset if he shoots like he's capable of.
Worley has six. He's 10 of 10. He hasn't missed one all year at the free throw line. He got that one down.
Sam Singh.
45-28. Andrews out. Sam Singh in. Six points, four boards for the junior. One more free throw coming up for Tracy Worley. 13-14 to play. Free throw, he missed his first of the season. Rebound is Singh. Give to J.J. Twy. Double, nice pass, J.J. inside to Somerville. Twy found him in the operating room, and it's 47-28 with 7 minutes gone in the second half.
14 for Somerville.
Fleetwood, Worley. Dickens open behind the back in the lane. Sam Singh fouls it. When Sam fouls you, you usually wind up where he did on his back. Second foul on Sam. Second team foul on the Braves. So 35 is Joe Dickens. He is 12 of 19, 63%. He has not scored tonight. Bradley 47, Delaware State 28. Free throw up, missed. Too long. That form was like what we saw from Zach at the beginning of the year. Remember coaching him as long on everything?
Yeah, he was.
Free throw number two, Dickens. That misses two. It was a takedown, and Jeremy Crouch winds up from the three spot, getting a rebound to Ray Brown, who look at a jump pass and throws it to nobody in particular. And J.J. Twy almost did a hurdle job and caught by one of Peoria's finest there. I don't know who that is, but he's got some quick hands. The Peoria Police Department on the job and on the spot. And saved J.J. Twy, who was about to tumble out of bounds. Braves maintain possession, and Twy has it. Get a ball screen from Somerville, but doesn't use it. Here's Jeremy Crouch from Brown. JC is doubled and stripped. Here's the outlet pass at the other end. A layup is up and missed. And a rebound taken down by Crouch again. And he's fouled and wasn't called. And then JJ Twy has the ball knocked from behind. Oh, it's like a pinball machine here.
Fisher's missed a good game that sequence, Dave.
Well, they want this thing to end as soon as everybody else does, I guess. 12-10 to play. Jeremy was tomahawk. There's a pass downstairs. Great look. And an attempted dunk is missed. And now we'll have a whistle. And a foul on Somerville, I think. Nope, 5-4. That's Singh again. And the third on Sam.
Sam's piling them up pretty quick.
Too bad with Crouch. Coach, he got a couple of rebounds there and made a very good play. And then it looked like he got mugged. 12-02 to play for the ball game. And to the free throw line, 33 is Joshua Block. Free throw short.
Well, they missed the last five free throws.
By the way, the young man, Timmy, who was the ball boy coach that got hit by Zach, his mom called the weekly show, the Jim Les Show, and he is fine.
Yeah, that's great.
47-28, one more. That's good. 47-29. Bradley's lead is 18. We'll have an official time and an exit ball, and Lawrence Wright will come in when that happens. J.J. Twy now to Brown. Crouch with it, directing traffic. Let's get one for Sam here. With it is Crouch. The count was on. Bounce passes to Singh between the rings. Puts the ball on the floor, drives all the way down, stops, fakes, walks, and turns it over. 11:42 to play. Lawrence Wright will come in. 14th Bradley turnover. At 11:42 to play, it's Bradley 47, Delaware State 29. Hornets ball and shine is in when we come back in a minute. You're listening to Bradley Rays Basketball on 1470 WMBD. Updated scores there, Courtney, for me real quick. Okay. Okay. Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, and Mike Sable at Carver Arena along with Dan DiOrio. Danny will have Braves Plus coming up at 6 o'clock on Wednesday night when Coach and I are down in Mississippi. Bradley Braves Basketball brought to you by Kelleher's Irish Pub and Eatery. When you enter your Irish, 100,000 welcomes wait you before and after every Bradley game at State and Water on Peoria's riverfront. And Bradley Basketball brought to you by Rainer Door of Peoria. Rainer Door, built to be worry-free. Call 579-2500 today. Oh, we got a sub in. This is the only guy we haven't seen.
They got Shine back in again, too, Dave.
Pichar is in. And we're going to have to look on him. This is his first action, I believe, of the season. You can't miss him, Coach. He's got the bald head out there.
He sure does.
In the backcourt is Dickens. Across the timeline is Shines on the break. Goes to the free throw line and comes back out. Bradley 47, Delaware State 29. Dickens behind the back, backs up Lawrence Wright, who's back in the game, is on him. Look and fake is Fleetwood. Stops, Dickens in the lane, jump stop, left-hander misses, Singh the rebound. Sam looked for the outlet pass and gives to J.J. Twy. Across the timeline is Crouch, free throw line extended left, try to pass to Lawrence Wright threw it away out of bounds. 15th Bradley turnover. J.J. Twy comes out. Ruffin is in. At 11-10. And the Braves up 18. Dickens, the count is 3. The count is 4. The count is 5. And there's a turnover. And Bennett is in. So the Bradley starting guards are back in with Bennett. Crouch is out. It's Bennett, Ruffin, Singh Brown, and Lawrence Wright.
Good defense on inbounds pass, Dave. Another turnover.
Florian Pichar from Germany. There's a bounce pass to Ruffin in the corner left. Sam Singh, turnaround jumper. Sam missed. Had a hooker that didn't go down. Stepped out of bounds right in front of the official. Yes, he did. Official says no. I believe he did. With it on the drive all the way down, lay it up and get it.
That was
right down the lane as Blunt scored 47-31. Bradley's lead down to 16. Singh look at the entry pass into Lawrence Wright, doesn't give it to him. Ray Brown around one, around two. Hangs, fires, missed it. Little rush there on the last two sequences. Shine behind the back. Across the timeline he comes. 10.5 to play for the game. Bradley 47, Delaware State 31. Shine all the way down to the lane. Penetrate and kick for a jumper for 3 is good. Corner left.
First three of the game for him.
Fleetwood hits the 3-point shot. It's 47-34. Back to 13. Andrews and Somerville. Next dead ball come in. Here's a lob to the basket. Weak side help is there. Shine, and he stepped out of bounds that time.
Nice weak side help by Shine, but he didn't step on the line.
And Somerville is in. And so is Andrews as Ray Brown comes out and Sam Singh comes out. So the Braves were at 18 a moment ago. It is now 13. It's inbound underneath the right goal. see what they run for an inbound this time. They've got a couple of layups tonight off of inbounds plays. This is on the right side. Look at Zach Andrews instead of Somerville. A ball fake to the baseline. He's doubled. Give to Lawrence Wright. Ooh, he had Zach open for a half a second. Didn't get it to it. Somerville will go back door. He didn't get the pass. Now Ruffin spins away around one, around two. Bounce pass, Tony Bennett layup. Good from Ruffin. Nice feed by Ruff. 9 points for Tony Bennett, 49 Bradley, 34 Delaware State, 9:50 to play. Shines with it. He's really quick, isn't he, Coach?
Yes, he is. And good basketball sense, too. Good passer.
Bouchard, the bounce passes to Dickens, now on the left. Fleetwood, a ball fake, doesn't take. Looks and gives a shine on the baseline, around one, around two. Crotches the shot. Zach Andrews the rebound. Kick it out rough. Running it to the other end. Finds Lawrence Wright, in and out of his hands, get it back. Lose it. Pushed. And foul.
And a whirling dervish that time. He's trying to get control of it, trying to get a shot.
He looked like a Roadrunner cartoon, didn't it, Coach? Where's the coyote? Dickens the foul, his second. Team foul number five. Lawrence Wright will in. Is he going to inbound this one? Yes. And gives to Bennett. Now to Ruffin. Gives to 2-3. Now it's a man. Penetrate rough, give to Somerville, three ball left is good.
17, another assist for Ruffin.
He's starting to pile them up, isn't he? 52 to 34, as Somerville hits the shot. And with it on the right is Dickens. Posting his Fleetwood downstairs, Dickens is fouled going in. With a left hand, he made the move and was fouled.
Somerville
picks it up. His first.
First foul on Somerville. Fourth on the Braves.
Fourth team foul, but we'll shoot him here with Dickens. And Kaheem Broadus, one of their better starters, is not here tonight. He had some eligibility issues. Dickens' free throw is good. 52 to 35 with 8:58 to play. Fleetwood out. What is your guess, Coach? How long is it going to take Roundtree to foul out here?
Well,
got
I'm
a
not
death,
sure.
Danny?
Well, no.
I think he will. 2 minutes, Danny says. 2 minute warning is given. 52 to 36. Both free throws are good.
Go,
with it is Ruff. He'll bring it across the timeline against Shines. Quick on quick here. Ruffin with it. Got a ball screen from Lawrence Wright. Now Bennett steps up. Zach Andrews steps up between the rings.
Well, Roundtree's guarding Zach. If he guards him around the basket, he'll fall out.
With it is rough. Try to break him down. Pull up jumper from 16 short. Rebound is long, and the Hornets have numbers. Here's Shine.
Nice
gives a Roundtree shot. It's blocked by Somerville. Then it's poked away by Zach Andrews, and Bennett went to help. And now they'll reload, and the ball's knocked away by Ruffin. Almost three steals, and then Bennett goes for the steal. And out of bounds. Defense, 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 and the crowd loves it. Passing lanes have now been closed.
Well, the ball's not in Shine's hand. It's an adventure out there.
16 on the shot clock as no possession was established. Shine's with it. Bichar is in there for just decoration, I think. He hasn't touched it. Lawrence Wright's on him, doing a pretty good job. Three on the shot clock, two on the shot clock. Blunt didn't get it up in time. I guess he did. And Roundtree gets the rebound. Everybody just kind of stood and watched. It was zero when the ball went up, but the horn didn't sound. There's Bichar has it. Give it to Shine. We'll have an official time in the next dead ball. Shine a crossover dribble around one, then threw the ball at the feet of Dickens, who fires the three in. Don't put on the line for two. 52 to 38, he has four. Ruffin with it, spins away, around one, around two, his own, lays up and missed, but he'll go to the line for a pair when we come back in a minute. Ruffin will have two free throws with 7:31 to play. Bradley 52, Delaware State 38. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on WMBD Peoria, Illinois. To 42, what time? Okay. 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 And Illinois State doesn't start till 9, I don't think. Okay.
Where did Drake play their game, Dave?
At San Jose State.
Huh.
Dave Snell, Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, Mike Sable, and Dan DiOrio back at Carver Arena. It looks like it might be up to Illinois State for the Valley to pitch a shutout today. They're winning them all. Bradley Braves basketball brought to you by Ford, your local Ford dealer, home of the new 2006 Ford Freestyle, built for the heartland, built for the road ahead, and by Avanti's. If you have a son or daughter between 8 and 12, register them to be an honorary ball boy or ball girl at any of the three Avanti's locations. Winners will be notified and announced prior to each home game. Jim Last Live, Monday, 6 to 7, before we head to Mississippi on 1470 WMBD. Coach?
Dave, Shine's got six assists. He has six assists for this team in a low-scoring game and not a very good shooting team. That's pretty impressive.
Daniel Ruffin to the line. He is 13 of 17, 77%. He'll have a pair here. Bradley 52, Delaware State 38, with 7:31 to play in the half. Bradley and Southern Mississippi from Hattiesburg on Wednesday night. And the horn sounds. I think that was the second horn. And Ruff to the line. Free throws rimming no good. A little flat with the first one. One more for Ruffin. Trying to get his third point of the night. Missed it. Rebound is back tipped, but it's taken down as Ruff comes up 0 for 2 by Worley. Gives to Dickens, who falls out of bounds and fouled by Wright because he was pushed out of bounds. Second foul on Lawrence Wright. 15th foul. It's Dickens, Worley, Roundtree, Kuchar. The ball knocked away by Somerville and then off a foot of Somerville out of bounds. Sellis diving for the ball, leading 52 to 38.
You got Shine on the bench again. I would be surprised if we get a steal.
So sideline right, it'll be Joe Dickens to inbound, and he does way back to Roundtree. Back to Dickens. He's up high right. Somerville is on him. Around Somerville, he flips. Good help by Lawrence Wright, who gets called for a third foul.
Well, they cleared, Dave. They cleared and put four men on the other side of the floor, and he came in and went one on two, and they had no shot at all, and just shot it into him and got called on the foul.
I don't know what more Boogie could have done on that play.
No, he was
straight up.
Right in front, but you get that call sometimes when you take the ball to the basket.
So Dickens to the line. He is 2 for 4. And missed that one. 7:15 to play. Bradley 52, Delaware State 38. Our magic number was 60. And the Braves will eventually get there. Free throw is up. And in and out, missed a pair. Another rebound for Lawrence Wright. That's 9. Somerville looks inside Zach Andrews. Zach is really working hard in the post.
Always does.
Right. Andrews up at the high post. Give it to Somerville. Looks left. Now gives it right to Ruffin. Lawrence Wright between the rings. Bennett with it. 15 on the shot clock. Tony has it. And pulls up his dribble. Gives to Ruffin. Shot clock reads 9. Bennett with 8, now 7. Tony want to get a ball screen with 6, now 5. Pull-up jumper from 17. That's good.
Tough shot.
With the shot clock running down, he's got 11. 54 to 38. We weren't going to get much out of that offensive set. 54 to 38. Shine will come in the next dead ball. Blunt with it, up high right, going to drive into the lane. It's a lot of one-on-one here, and he made the layup.
Made a nice drive. He generally can't get in there with that defense.
54-40, back to a 14-point Bradley lead. Somerville with it. Looks at Zach Andrews. Instead, he drives on Pichar, and that's no contest as he blocked him on the baseline. As Sellis will go to the line for one and bonus. Pichar's second free foul. Shines is in for him now. 6:14 to play in the game. Bradley 54 and Delaware State 40. Coach, when I was preparing for this, I knew what we were preparing for.
Well, you have been disappointed, probably.
No. 17 for Somerville, 2 of 2 from the line. Short rebound is taken away. Another one by Lawrence Wright, got the layup in. That'll give him a double-double, 13 and 10. He's got 15 now without that deuce. 56 to 46 minutes to play in the game. Bradley's lead is 16. He's like 32 the way they play. Nice pass inside. Turnaround jumper, Worley is blocked by Somerville into Fleetwood, who made the shot. They got the loose ball, make it Dickens got it. Dickens the score, 56 to 42. A good initial block by Somerville. With it is Tony Bennett. Free throw line extended on the right. Looks at Ruffin. Tony's going to take it with the left hand in the lane and then back out. Put on the floor. Now gets his dribble. Looks and flips to Ruffin. Lawrence Wright, now Somerville. Shines on him. Lob into Zach Andrews. Is doubled. Stops, turns. Short shot. Good. Turnaround. Tough shot from six. Zach has eight. 58. 42. We're 2 points away from that magic winning number, which is perfect on the season, by the way. With it is Shines. Bounce passes Roundtree. He's not going to shoot it from out there, is he?
I wouldn't think so.
With it is Blunt. Free throw line extended to the right. He will, a three ball. Missed it wide right. Or wide left, actually, from the right side. Somerville the rebound. Give to Ruffin across the timeline under 5 minutes. Passes to Somerville on the baseline. He had it in a position where he likes to shoot behind the board, but didn't that time. On the baseline on the right. Ruffin gives to Wright. Now it's Bennett. Tony looks inside at Zach Andrews, who's trying to post against Roundtree. A three ball, Somerville. That's good.
It's a 4-3 tonight, Dave.
61-42, 20 points for Somerville. His career high is 28. He won't be in that long. And the Braves get to the magic number. Somerville's holding away from play as he was holding Dickens. Grabbed his shirt. Here comes Will Franklin in. Second foul on Somerville. One in bonus time for Dickens.
Fouls on Somerville is second.
Two fours come in. Phil Brown comes in for Ruffin. Let's see, they have Ruff for five assists on the night. We've probably seen the last of him, I would imagine, unless things bog down here.
And they're not going to score that fast, Dave, or that many.
61 to 42. Free throw is missed. Zach Andrews a rebound. He's going to bring it up himself. Oh, my goodness. What's going to happen now? He gives it to Somerville, who has a ball fake. Skip pass, Lawrence Wright. Drop down pass. Kaboom! For Zach Andrews!
Well, I'll tell you, Lawrence Wright's been a much better passer this year than last year, Dave.
What a great look that was. And Zach threw it down. He's double figures, 10. Shines with it. Out front gets double. 63-42. Zach almost a steal. Did cause the walk. Oh, he's getting in gear. I knew when he flew down on that break, Coach, when he had the ball himself, something might happen. And he did. He got the slam dunk. Great pass by Lawrence Wright. High low to his teammate. Dropped down and then very quick dunk.
Lawrence is looking to make that pass more this year.
16th turnover for Delaware State. Bradley 63. Hornets 42, 3:51 to play. Back in a minute. You're listening to Bradley Braves Basketball on 1470 WMBD. Now Joe Stoll, Jim Watson, Mike Sable, and Andy Oriole back. at Carver Arena. Bradley Breeze Basketball is brought to you by Avani's. If you have a son or daughter between 8 and 12, register them to be an honorary ball boy or ball girl at any of the three Avani's locations. Winners will be notified and announced prior to each home game. And by Paradise, go to Las Vegas this February for the big game party, courtesy of Paradise Hotel Casino. Prime reward members earn entries through January 15th with slot and table game play and double entries on Monday. Coach, how's the assist to turnover look?
It was about even. Dave was plus four now, 19 and 15. 19 up, 15 down.
Four blocks, seven steals for the Braves.
Stats in our entire front line, Somerville, Andrews, and Wright, very good tonight.
63 to 42. The Bradley lead is 21 with 3:42 to play. Crouch with it. They're in the zone. A bad pass, Jeremy. I don't know where he was throwing that. Down at the other end, a layup by Shines is up and good. I don't know if it slipped out of his hands or what, but he turned it over. 3.5 to play, 63 to 44. Lawrence Wright, a jump stop, looks in, comes back out. Will Franklin, who's back in the game, give it to Brown. Zach Andrews wants it so bad he can taste it. With it is Crouch. Ball fake, no shot. Now Franklin, 18 on the shot clock. Andrews with it out high, holds it like a loaf of bread. And now goes to the basket. Drop down pass, Boogie. Kaboom!
Nice job that time. Nice pass from Zach.
You got these numbers flying everywhere, Coach.
Good to see our big players make passes like that.
Good interior passing. 65 to 44. With 2:48 to play. With it is Roundtree. Looks. 17 points for Lawrence Wright, by the way. There's a bounce pass. In the corner, a jumper fired up by Blunt is in and out. Ray Brown the rebound. Watts right to Lawrence Wright's name down there. With it is Franklin. Up high right. Now with a left-hand dribble, backs up. Count's taken off a little bit. 2:23 to play. 65 to 44 is the Bradley lead. Franklin beats one, beats two. Crouch. Give to Lawrence Wright. Now Crouch, Will Franklin. 14:13 on the shot clock. Franklin's going to get doubled and step in between two, and he'll have a chance to score the first points of his Bradley career, as that's the ninth team foul for the Hornets. Phillip Brown picks it up.
Will Franklin shoots 1 point.
So with 2:08 to play in the game, he'll have a chance to make his first points as a Bradley Brave. Adams Heemskirk coming in. Free throw, Will, in and out. Rebound is back tipped and picked up by Phillip Brown to Shines, who flips the pass with 2 minutes to go in the game. 65 to 44, the Bradley lead is 21. And Brown backs up near the timeline. Don't need to be in a hurry now, I guess. With it, Shines, with a minute 49, 48, get a ball screen and a switch. Zach Andrews has a smaller man. Here's driving in the lane, Worley. His shot is up and good off the glass. 65 to 46. Bradley's lead is 19 with a minute 36 to go. With it, Brown. Ray gets doubled. Gets to Lawrence Wright. Jump pass is picked up by Andrews. Back pass is to Crouch, whose three ball is good.
I think he's hit his last two, Dave.
JC for three. And it is 68 to 46. Roundtree with it, and Brian Lavin will get into the game. Rich, who's listening in Tokyo, 68 to 46. I hope he gets in. They got to be a dead ball first. 104 to go. And there's a double. Shines dribbles around one, around two. Here's Fleetwood's jumper for three. Missed it. Rebound taken down. Zach Andrews. Ray Brown on a bust out. Now stop. Stutter step dribble. Gives to Crouch. Jeremy with it. Now Franklin. And a timeout called by Jim Less. And all they want to do is get the guys back in the game. Heemskirk, Lavin, and Danny Adams. And that's the reason they're not going to take the timeout. They just want to get the players in. And with 48.3, 68 to 46. Now, can we get Brian Lavin a score here, Coach?
You got to get in the ball. Against the zone, you could.
Franklin with it, 24, 23 on the shot clock. Lavin's driving the baseline.
He's got Roundtree's guarding him, Dave.
He set a ball screen at him. He'd squat. He'd just get splatted. Lavin with it out near the timeline. Shot clock is 10, now 9. Get a screen from Heemskerk. Give to Will Franklin. His first basket, no. Rebound is taken away by the Hornets, and that probably is going to do it. They'll probably go for one. Roundtree with it with 16. Now 15, 14 seconds. Shine with it with 13, 12. Bradley's going to go to 5 and 2. 68 to 46. Pretty good job defensively, and not much offense for Delaware State. And that's a Bradley winner as the shot at the horn misses. 68 to 46. The Braves go to 5 and 2 on the season and head to Mississippi. And we're one game away from Patrick O'Brien's return.
Where are you going to play him, Dave? The way the front line's playing.
I think I might find a place.
Find a place. But it's good to see. It's good to see both. All Marcellus and
right,
Lawrence, and, right. Zach Andrews really made a
playing a ton, and Sam Singh continues to play well as well. So the Braves win it by the score of 68 to 46. They were never really in trouble in this game. Back with a post-game show coming up. We'll have Missouri Valley Conference scores and more. Stay tuned for the Central Illinois Bank post-game show coming up next.
Six players scored, Dave. That's kind of surprising.
Really?